Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So I want to recognize, obviously, our British ambassador, Mr. Philip Perham, and each of you to be here and enjoy your time, especially have fun as well. Take care. Thank you.
There's a poem by a 19th century English poet called Arthur Hugh Clough, very short, that I'm going to read to you, which is about the importance of not losing heart and not giving up, even if progress comes slowly. And it goes like this. Say not the struggle nought availeth, the labour and the wounds are vain. The enemy faints not, nor faileth, and as things have been, they remain. If hopes were dupes, fears may be liars. It may be in yon smoke concealed, your comrades chase even now the flyers, and but for you possess the field. For while the tired waves, vainly breaking, seem here no painful inch to gain, far back, through creeks and inlets making, comes silent, flooding in the main. And not by eastern windows only, where daylight comes in the light. In front, the sun climbs slow, how slowly. But westward, look, the land is bright. So I would say to all of you, say not the struggle, nor to bail. Thank you very much.
As a Pakistani, seeing these atrocities committed by my own country has been very difficult. Growing up, my parents always told me about the Muslim struggle to create their own independent Pakistan. They gladly told me about our Qaid, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. He was the man who led Pakistan to independence. They read me our renowned poet, Allama Iqbal's poetry before bed, even though I understood nothing. But they sheltered me from the very premise our land was built on. As a person with strict rules and morals, I am not one to stand with those in the wrong. We're here to discuss the ideas and exchange them. There's a saying that goes, I had a dollar, I met a man with a dollar. We both exchanged our dollars, and now we both had $1. I had an idea, I met a man with an idea. After we exchanged our ideas, we both had two ideas. Thank you all for listening. Hopefully Admun 2015 will be a success story, one to tell the grandkids. I now yield the floor to the doctor.
A lot of the time we question the significance of the action we want to take. We question ourselves as to what action we can take that will be significant towards the issues being discussed, the massive issues. And on that note, I'd like to tell you that not only do small deeds go a long way, but if words have been used to fuel the wars of our past, then surely they can be used to resolve the conflicts of our present. Mahatma Gandhi achieved independence for an entire nation using nothing but compassion and words. Mandela put his people out of apartheid purely as a narrator. Martin Luther King Jr. ended the oppression of the blacks through nothing but his speech. Sometimes simply putting our voices out there on a tapestry of words can be more effective than anything we could ever imagine. Why don't we fight these wars with our strongest weapons? Why don't we fight them with words? These are the future and the light. I'd like to end this speech with a quote from the doctor. The doctor once famously said, I am and always will be the optimist, the hope of far-flung hopes and the dream of improbable dreams. So what reason does that give us not to hope for a better world and to dream of a better future? Thank you.